Let's talk a little bit about factors and just give some definitions before we go off into their use. So let's talk about factors. Before we start, let's define a factor. And you should remember this way back when from chapter 1. A factor is simply any number that divides evenly. So, for example, if we have the number 12, factors of 12 are 3 and 4. Other factors of 12 are 6 and 2. Other factors of 12 are 12 and 1. So these are all factors right here because these are all numbers that divide 12 evenly. So that's a factor. Now, let's define a prime number. Prime number is actually pretty interesting, and it's specifically, by definition, a natural number greater than 1 whose only factors are 1 and itself. So, for example, a number like 12 would not be prime because it has factors of 6, 2, 3, 4, so on and so forth. But the number 2 would be prime because the number 2 isn't divisible by anything other than 2 and 1. So I can list out the first few prime numbers. They are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, so on and so forth. And one question you may ask yourself is, well, how many prime numbers are there? And the truth is that there are an infinite number of prime numbers, and we could keep on calculating them as much as we want. So if we have a definition for a prime number, you might imagine, well, what's it called when a number is not prime? And we call that a composite number. And a composite number, by definition, is a natural number greater than 1 that is not prime. Okay, so now that we know what these definitions are, let's talk about finding the prime factorization of a number. Now, this is essentially when a composite number is written as a product of prime numbers. So let me give you an example of that. Let's start with the number 12. First of all, you should agree that this is a composite number. It's a composite number because it is greater than 1 and it's not prime. So we can find any two factors of 12. And let's find the factors 3 and 4. And it doesn't really matter which factors you find as long as they multiply to give you 12. And then you ask yourself, okay, is 3 a prime number? 3 is a prime number, so we can stop there. Then you ask yourself, is 4 a prime number? 4 is not a prime number. 4 breaks down into the factors 2 and 2. And then you ask yourself, are 2 and 2 prime numbers? And they actually are. So when you have nothing but prime numbers, that is called your prime factorization. So my circled numbers are my prime factorization. And what I can do is I can write 12 as a product of primes. I can write 12 as 3 from over here times 2 from over here times 2 from over here. And that is the prime factorization of 12. And it actually turns out that there's only one prime factorization for every number. So it doesn't matter if you started with 3 or 4 or 2 or 6, any two factors, you would have ended up in the same prime factorization, which is 3 times 2 times 2. So I could give you some examples. I could ask you to find the prime factorization of the following. Let's try finding the prime factorization of 30. Well, you start by asking yourself, what are factors of 30? Factors of 30 are 3 and 10. 3 happens to be prime, so I can stop there. 10 is not, so I can break down 10 some more. I can break down 10 into 2 and 5. And those are both prime, so I can stop there. So the prime factorization of 30 is 2 times 3 times 5. 2, 3, and 5. I'll give you a couple of more examples for you to try out. You should find the prime factorization of 56 and of 72. And you should be able to do that fairly easily. Sometimes it may be difficult to come up with whether a number has a prime factor or has factors now, whether it is prime. So there are some divisibility tests that you can use to check that out. And what I'll do is I'll post that up with this lecture so you can check it out. So you should look at the divisibility tests. And you would use a divisibility test to see, for example, if you were trying to find the prime factorization of the number 132, that's a little bit of a higher number, so we would run some divisibility tests on that to see what are factors of 132.